Well, here we are today looking at this idea of finding a lowest common denominator. Now, look at the example I've picked. Don't you guys recognize this? I'm sure you do. How do you find the lowest common denominator of three different fractions? Now, we've been doing this since elementary school. Now, we're going to review the process so that you can apply it to your Algebra 1 content, okay? Well, Ms. Kleiber, you kind of picked some tough fractions here. Look at these denominators. What was I thinking? Well, let's break it down. Boom, 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 boom. Okay, 18. We know that 18 is, we can factor that to 3 times 6, and then 6 can be broken down to 2 times 3. So we end up with 2 times 3 squared. Beautiful. 20, we can break that down to 4 times 5, and then we have 2 times 2, so we have 2 squared times 5. And last of all, 27, 3 times 9, so we end up with 3 cubed. Now, do you remember in elementary school then, once you have these prime factorizations, how do you find the common denominator? Huh, interesting. Well, for a common denominator, they all have to multiply into that number. So let's take it one number at a time. Let's look at the twos. So if you notice here at the twos, we've got 2 to the first power, whoa, and then we also have 2 to the second power. So they both have to multiply into it. So we're going to take the greatest value, the exponent with the greatest value of a base 2. So then that would mean then we would do 2 squared, okay? So I'm playing with my new app, if you can't tell. So 2 squared is going to be part of the LCD. Oops, I need to go to pen mode. 2 squared. Now let's look at the next number, the 3s. So on the 3s, we have a 3 squared and we have a 3 cubed. I have to remember to push that each time. Whoa! Well, wow, I didn't do that well. So 3 cubed. So which one will both numbers go into? Well, it has to be 3 to the third power. So times 3 to the third power. Now let's look at the last factor, 5. Now we notice that 5 is only represented here once. So it would be times 5. So then the greatest common denominator is going to be 2 squared, which is 4, times 27 times 5. And that would be our lowest common denominator. I think I said a wrong phrase there. Okay. Now let's move on. Let's try another one. Okay. Now you try this process on these fractions. So I'd like you to stop the video and try it and then come back and check your work. Make sure you show all of your work because I'm going to be checking these notes in class tomorrow. Okay, now that I'm sure you've all checked your work, so let's break down these problems. So we've got 54. So we know 54 is 9 times 6, which is 3 times 3 times 2 times 3. So we have 3 cubed, 2 times 3 cubed. 45 is 5 times 9, so we have 3 squared. Times 5. Do you guys remember this from elementary school? I hope you do. And then we've got 2 times 2. So we have 2 squared times 5. So then now our lowest common denominator, so all three fractions have to be able to multiply into that number. So let's look at the first numeral, 2. Which one has the greatest exponent? 2 squared. Let's look at the next numeral. The next factor would be 3. What is the one with the greatest exponent? 3 cubed. And last of all, the last factor is 5, and we notice that's the first power. You multiply these three factors together, and that will be your lowest common denominator. So see, at this point, we've just reviewed everything you learned in elementary school. Now, how can we apply this to algebra? I knew you were asking that question. Okay, so here we have two algebraic fractions, 6a squared b and 5b squared c. So let's factor these monomials. Well, we know 6 is 2 times 3, and then we have a squared b, okay? And then 5, prime factorization, would be 5 times b squared c. So we look at the factors of our two denominators, and we look to see what would be the lowest common denominator. Well, 6 and 5, what do those two numbers go into? They would go into 30. Now look at your next factor, a. We have an a squared. What's your next factor? The b's. Which one has the greatest exponent? B squared. And last of all would be the factor c. This is our lowest common denominator for these two fractions. Now, let's try it with one problems where the denominator is not a monomial, rather it's a binomial. So again, we repeat the process in that we factor. So this denominator would be 5 times a quantity, k plus 2. And the second denominator, I recognize it, difference of two squares, would be the quantity k plus 2 times a quantity k minus 2. Now let's repeat the process and let's look at each factor. Which factor has the greatest value, the greatest exponent? So we have 5, okay, and then we've got some binomials. We have a k plus 2 to the first power, and our last factor is k minus 2. So that would be our lowest common denominator for these two algebraic fractions. Now, last of all, we're going to do this example. Now, in class tomorrow, we're going to practice this more, but you've got to have the basics down. So the first fraction here, we have 3 over c times the quantity c minus 6. And then the second fraction is 5 over c times the quantity c plus 6. So let us look for the lowest common denominator. Now, what is the process for finding the lowest common denominator? After your denominators are factored, look at each factor. Which factor has the greatest exponent? Well, we have a factor of c to the first power, we have a factor of c plus 6, and we have a factor of c minus 6. This will be my common denominator. So if I rewrite each fraction with the new common denominator, the new common denominator is c plus 6 times c minus 6. Can you hear the copying in the background? I'm hiding out in the photocopy room. Okay, so now we look at the denominator. So when we look at the denominator, we see here, this is our original denominator. Now what changed with the new denominator? What additional factor am I multiplying by? I'm multiplying by c plus 6. So my new numerator will be 3 times the quantity c plus 6. Now look at the other fraction. So we look at that. Here's the original denominator. Now what did I multiply by to get the new denominator with the lowest common denominator? C minus 6. So my new numerator will be 5 times the quantity c minus 6. So now I have just created equivalent fractions with the lowest common denominator.